Well, you are most welcome to Me and Geography. That is my YouTube channel. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for all those who have subscribed, those who have viewed my work. Thank you very much. May you be blessed. Well, today we are back. We are still trying to put down that topic of field work, and we want to start from where we stopped. The YouTube channel is Me and Geography. Pass there, view, subscribe, and support this common cause. Today, we want to look at the problems faced during field work. When you go for research or when you go to the field to get information, don't expect an environment which is 100% welcoming. Trust me, here or there, you're going to have a few challenges. So that's what we want to discuss today. What are some of those problems that you are likely to face or that you face while carrying out field work? I want to start with an NB, that the problem faced in fieldwork should have stopped you from getting the information you're looking for. What do I mean? You don't mention a problem that hasn't affected you. In other words, if you go to the field, the problem you face must have stopped you from getting a particular information that you were looking for when you went there. Therefore, I want to give you examples of those problems. I'm going to show you how to explain them so that I give you the rest of the problems that you will have to explain on your own. Bring out the aspects of what I have been meaning by saying the problem faced in the field should have stopped you from getting the information you're looking for. For example, when you say abrupt rainfall that wetted our notebooks, hence we were unable to note down the problems faced by the people. You can mention the area where you went for your field work. So in other words, the problem is abrupt rainfall. Yes. So how did it stop you from getting the information you went to get in the field? For example, this researcher here, maybe I went to the field to get the problems faced by the people at a learning site, so to say. So in other words, it is a problem because the rainfall wetted my notebooks. And then because it's not in my notebooks, therefore, I could not get the problems. Why? Because I did not write them anywhere. Not the language we use, abrupt rainfall. Don't say heavy rainfall. No, abrupt rainfall means it comes or when you least expect it. That's one of the problems. Two, we can look at inaccessibility of the area. Maybe you mentioned that local name of the place where you went for fieldwork. Let's say you did fieldwork on a market. Or on a learning site. What is the name of that site? What is the name of that market? So inaccessibility due to maybe due to the steep slopes. What is the name of that steep slope? Let's say where I went, the name of the area is called Kaiso. So I say inaccessibility due to the Kaiso steep slope that hindered me from seeing. What did it hinder me from seeing? The land use types. West of Kaiso Hill. That is the area where I went. So can you also mention that area where you went? In other words, there must have been a problem whereby something, maybe a physical feature like a steep slope, stopped you from accessing a particular area. So you say, inaccessibility due to Kaiso steep slope that hindered me from seeing the land use types. West, when you put there a direction, it brings out the aspect of geography. West of, mention the name of that hill. So in other words, your main interest was the land use types, just as I've underlined. And then, what was the problem? Inaccessibility. How did it stop you? Obstructed you. Or made it inaccessible or unable for you to reach that particular area. Next, we look at shortage of measuring tools. Hence, we fail to establish what are the measuring tools. Let's say you didn't have a weighing scale and you wanted to ascertain maybe the weight of a Nile patch. So you say, shortage of measuring tools. Hence, we fail to establish the weight of a Nile patch at Kasenyi or Kaiso Fish Learning Site. That is, if you went to a learning site, shortage of measuring tools. Therefore, you were unable. You went there to ascertain the weight of a mature patch. But because you didn't have what you needed, therefore, you are unable to establish something or what the aspect you're interested in. For that case, which is the weight of a Nile patch. Limited representative samples. This applies to the method of sampling. When you go to the site, you're not going to ask everyone who is at that site. You just need to get one person to represent the many. Because we said in sampling, it means you get part of a whole to represent that whole. So in other words, we are saying limited representative samples, whereby we fail to establish the various fish preservation methods used at Kaiso Fish Learning site. Maybe the people you talk to could not bring out the various preservation methods. The samples were not adequate for you to get the real information you are looking for. That's another problem. Noise pollution. When you talk about the problem of noise pollution, talk about the source. Where was the noise coming from? So it's a noise pollution from, you mentioned maybe there is a trading center or a nearby market that hindered us from establishing there. You mentioned the information that you missed. Okay? Dash of maybe that area where I went. Let's talk about a particular market. Maybe you say noise pollution from maybe Wachiseka market that hindered me from establishing the future plans of Wachiseka Kaiso, Wachiseka Trading Center, etc. That is just a hint of some of the problems. So some of the other problems, for our interest of time, I want to give you some of the other problems you may not as a scholar. But then, don't forget the aspect of the problem should have stopped you from getting a particular information that you are looking for. Two, NB2, that I ought to note there. The problem should not be personal. Yeah, I have faced challenges with this whereby some students come and say, okay, Master, me, I was hungry. Therefore, I face a problem of hunger. Mm-mm, that is personal. If you felt hunger, you think everyone else felt hunger? No. A lot of sunshine, that is not a good problem. Why? People can endure the sunshine. But we say abrupt rainfall because very few people can withstand rainfall. So therefore, hunger is a personal problem. Never write it. Someone who gets tired, I got tired very fast. That's not a problem because it is personal. It didn't affect you in getting information from the field. Yes. Then some of you may equally note problems such as long distances. It is not a problem. People walk. How did it stop you from getting a particular information? That is just personal problems. We don't write personal problems. So some of the other problems as written there, you can go through them. I gave you my WhatsApp number. Those who are interested, you can write essays about those problems and forward them to my number. We can chat more about them. The number is 0703-442054. Note me, reach me out there, and then we shall discuss those other problems in details. Okay, we continue. I want to give you some sample questions about the problems faced during fieldwork. Students, learners, and scholars, don't confuse problems faced during fieldwork with disadvantages of the methods of data collection. Do not confuse them. So some of the sample questions include, outline the problems you faced during your fieldwork. Outline the problems you faced during your fieldwork. And then we have, what problems did you face while carrying out your fieldwork study? Those are general questions. They want the problems faced. Outline the limitations of using the above methods of data collection. In other words, here they want you to state the method of data collection and then the problems you faced while using it, not the disadvantages of that method, but the problems while using it. Then we go to, what problems did you encounter while using the methods in above? That's almost the same as the second last one. Not state the method and then give the problem you faced while using that method. Let me give you a simple example. A student may say, observation. What problems did you face? You say, obstruction by maybe Kaiso Hill that prevented me from seeing the land use types west of the hill. That is the problem. Don't confuse it with a disadvantage. That is a problem in that case. So therefore, we can continue and say, we go and look at our next subtopic, which is drawing a sketch map of the area studied. All right. When you're asked to draw a sketch map of the area studied, I'm going to give you basics because I'll not draw a sketch map. Reason being, I don't know where I went. You don't know where I went. But I can give you the basics. What are some of those basics? Your sketch map should bear a complete title. What do I mean a complete title? It should have all the features that have been asked in the question. If they say, draw a sketch map of the area studied, on it mark a name, physical features and land use types. In other words, your title should have whatever is in the question. A sketch map of blah, 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 showing physical features and land use types. That is very good. That's what we call a complete title, a complete title. Then we go on. It should have a boundary. Qualities of a good map. It should have a boundary. It should have a key to explain the symbols used. It should have a compass direction. It should have a proper labeling, in other words. It should not be so squeezed. It should be proper, well elaborated, as a real geographer would do. Okay. Let's continue. And we look at some of the questions that may be asked. Then we interpret them. And then we can see what next. Sample questions about drawing sketch map. You can say, draw a sketch map of the area studied. And on it mark a name. Relief features. Land use types. I want to break that down. Students normally draw whatever comes to their mind. But here they have been elaborate. They have said relief features. What are some of the relief features? A simple approach. The relief features, if you go to the field and do research, relief refers to the general appearance of the landscape. So what are some of those features that reflect the general appearance of the landscape? We have, for example, hills, steep slopes, gentle slopes, flatlands, valleys, outcrop rocks, saddles, etc. But make sure that when you're drawing them on your sketch map, they should have local names or names of local examples. Are we together? Then we can go and say, the land use types. What are some of the land use types you expected to note from the area of study? When you go to the field, did you observe? Are there settlements? Are there plantations? Are there markets? Are there shops? Are there trading centers? Are there roads? Hotels? Maybe you went to a farm and you're seeing some palaces. Those are some of the land use types. So make sure when you draw a sketch map, you indicate them, giving them their local names. That's what makes you a researcher. There should be local names. Okay. As I noted down there, the local names must be stated. For example, I gave you some of them, Kaiso Hill, Kaiso Trading Center, and then many others. Question two about still drawing sketch maps. Draw a sketch map of the area studied, and on it mark and label. This time they have not said relief features. This time they have made it clear. Physical features. They are not the same members. They are not the same. In other words, what are some of the physical features? This time let's look at these physical features. Physical features in this case they are categorized in relief features. The other one was saying draw a sketch map, mark and name relief features. Now, this time they have said physical features. So amongst the physical features, features that exist on their own, we have relief features. For example, hills, gentle slopes, steep slopes, etc. Then drainage features. These are also examples of physical features. Lakes, rivers, streams, rivers, stock streams, swamps, ponds, waterfalls, etc. Then three, vegetation. For example, grasslands, forests, and other types of vegetation. Maybe thickets, etc. So here the examiner requires you, if you have been asked to draw a sketch map of the area studied, and on it mark and label physical features, here the examiner expects you to mark to mark one relief feature, mark a drainage feature, also indicate a vegetation type. Don't just draw a sketch map and only show relief features. You're likely to score one mark. If there are 2 marks, you're likely to score one, or if there are 3 marks. But mark at least a relief feature, indicate at least a drainage feature, and then a vegetation type. Then the other part I've already discussed, the land use types. And don't forget that their local names must be stated of those features. If you're saying there is a lake, what is the name of the lake? Is it Lake Albert? Is it Lake Victoria? Mention the name of the lake. If it's a river, mention its river. I mean, mention its name. If there are swamps, mention the name of that swamp. If it's a pond, mention the name of that pond. So basically, that is what we want to look at in that case. Well, I want to take this opportunity to say it was such a wonderful time with you today. It was such a wonderful time with you today. Catch you later in the next episode. I will continue to call upon you to subscribe to my channel. The channel is Me and Geography. Capital A and Capital G, Geography. Thank you very much for viewing. I wish you a very, very blissful time. Thank you.